Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now, let us see about 100 conversion in organic chemistry. We are seeing it as episodes. This is the episode number 90. If you didn't watch previous episodes, I encourage you to go and see. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. Let us see the question number 1. The starting metal we have cyclopentane and attached with quaternary ammonium salt which have positive charge, which is compensated by OH there. Then you are having the methyl. They ask you to find the product. There are the two possibilities for the product, P and Q there. The P is the major product, Q is the least product, which is 9%. Here the possibilities are given. The alkene formation. Of course, the alkene formation. Where the alkene will be formed? Alkene will be formed exocyclic or inside the compound, or which is P, which is Q. The position of double bond is the real question here. So from the reactant to product, you might understand that the selective elimination, you can say naming elimination. The answer is C. Let us see how. The starting metal you have quaternary ammonium salt, which is very much unstable because it possesses the charge. You are simply heating there. So what will be happen? It will try to eliminate itself. But here the two possibilities. Which hydrogen will leave? Whether the hydrogen in the methyl group or in the ring hydrogen. The methyl hydrogen leave mean the product is P. The ring hydrogen leaves mean the product is Q. So which is major? Let us see about little bit mechanism and types of elimination. This elimination is called Hofmann elimination. Less substituted product is formed. Why? Because always bulky leaving group leads to the Hofmann elimination. Here we have quaternary ammonium salt which is attached with methyl group. Those are bulky. Why it's happened? It can be best understood by the stearic effect, because you have tried in the conformation. So if you write the conformation, the leaving group should be anti, because it's kind of E2 mechanism. For E2 mechanism, leaving groups should be anti to each other, or you can say anti periplanar to each other. So here hydrogen and amine periplanar to each other. P, there is a no problem because the free hydrogen pre-methyl, because pre-methyl group does not have any stearic effect. But you look at Q, you have the methylene one, it has the repulsion from the quaternary ammonium salt. Hence, anti-periplanar position is not possible. The stearic effect don't allow the anti-form here. So the elimination is least favored there. Possible, but least favored here. So P is the major product, Q is the least one. So definitely the answer is C. Here you have to learn two important things. Hofmann elimination always favor with the bulky leaving group, because bulky leaving group decides the repulsion between the nearby atoms. Second thing is the elimination followed by E2 mechanism, which always favor the anti position, or you can say anti periplanar elimination. Then the question number 2. The starting metal is cyclopentadiene. You have alkene with acid group. You are using the heat and N bromosuccinamide. They ask you to find the product. The product new bicyclic system is formed and the bromination occur in the system. The position of bromine and position of the acid group is important here. So how the carbonyl group reacts with the bromine is the question here. So the stereochemistry here is important. So from the reactant to product, you might understand that ring closure and bicyclic system is definitely formed, and stereochemistry equally played the role here. The answer is B. Let us see how. The starting metal you have conjugated iron and you are using the alkene. So there is a 4+2 cycloaddition. The 4+2 cycloaddition always favor the N2 product. This is a very important fact, because it is sterically hindered kinetic product, but it is a major one. So you have the endo acid group. Then next step, you are using the NBS. NBS is the bromine supplier which will brominate the alkene there. So bromination occurred. You have bromine with positive charge. So definitely you have the acid and bromine. So the backside attack is possible. So where the attack will be there? Attack can be on any side, which is the bromine, both sides are possible. But the 5-member ring is very stable with the hetero system. But in cyclohexane, 6-member is stable. But with hetero system, 5-member is stable. So what really happened is bromine is above the plane and 5-member cyclic is below the plane. So the answer is definitely B. The minor product is 6-member heterocyclic ring, major product is 5-member heterocyclic ring. Here you have learned two important things. One is cycloaddition reaction always favor the endo product even though it is sterically hindered and kinetic. Second thing is ring stability. With hetero atom, 5-member ring is stable rather than 6-member ring. Let us see the question number 3. The starting metal contains cycloazine which is attached with hydrogen with tosylate and you have the fourth position dimethyl group. You are using the butyl lithium and benzaldehyde. They ask you to find the product. The products are differ in the alkene position where the alkene bond is there, where the alkene is there, or nitrogen retained in the group, or the position of benzaldehyde carbon attack. So there are the possibilities. The alkene position and the aldehyde position is contributing here. So the benzaldehyde position and position of alkene group is important here. From the reactant tosylated hydrogen, you might guess the Nehme reaction is involved and definitely new C-C bond is formed here. The answer is B. Let us see how. The starting metal you have tosylated hydrogen, you have many active hydrogen, the acid hydrogen, you are using butyl lithium. So all the hydrogens are replaced by the lithium because it abstracts the proton, lithium compensates the charges there. Here tosylate is a very good leaving group, it triggers the further reaction and the electron travel to the nitrogen. The next step, nitrogen also good leaving group, so nitrogen leaves and leave the charge on the ring. So you have alkene anion, next step you are in the benzaldehyde. So what really happened is anion attack the carbonyl group, you have the product. So the product is clearly B. Here you have to know two important things. One is supplier elimination. Supplier elimination contains two good leaving groups, which is N2 and TS, which leads to the alkene with active hydrogen, or you can say anion. Second thing is charge travels. Whenever you have good leaving group, always charge travel to the leaving group and help to the elimination. Then the question number 4. The starting metal you have heaton, which have 2 alpha deuterium and bromine. You are using the base. So there are the possibilities, ring contraction is there. And the position of deuterium and position of Br is the question here. So Br is removed or not, or which deuterium is removed, or which deuterium is migrated. So from the starting material, alpha halohedron, you might guess the Nehme reaction is involved and definitely ring contraction is occur. The answer is D. Let us see how. The starting metal you have heton and you have 2 deuterium, which is like acidic hydrogen. So you can remove by aqueous innova because it abstract the proton. So proton abstraction will be there, anion is formed one. So once the deuterium is absorbed, you have anion, you have good leaving group. So what really happened is the anion helped the leaving group better, which is bromine. So bromine elimination occur, new 3-member ring is formed. So anion attack bromine, bromine leaves there. So you have strained 3-member ring, but the ring can be opened by simple OH attack. We are using the base there. So ring can open either in the one way or two way because the ring is symmetrical, nothing affects more. So one attack leads to the product C, two attack leads to the product B. So there are equal possibilities. So the product is a mixture of B and C, which is the answer D there. Here you have to learn two important things. One is Favorsky rearrangement. If you have alpha haloheton, you might think of Favorsky rearrangement. Second thing is the ring is going from 6-member system to 5-member system. Why? Because the charge quenching is the driving factor here. The charge is more powerful than the ring size and ring stability. Then the question number 5. Starting metal you have cyclopentadiene and maleic anhydride. You are using the heat. They ask you to find the product. The product really the question of which addition is occurred. So both double bonds are involved, or only one double bond is involved, or the addition is syn addition, or the addition is trans addition. So the whole question is about regioselectivity and stereochemistry. So from the reactant and product, you might guess whole question is about regioselectivity versus stereochemistry. The answer is B. Let us see how. The starting metal you have conjugated ion, you are using maleic anhydride. Here you have 4+2 cycloaddition, hence the bridged carbon is formed there. So 5-member ring becomes 6-member with 1 bridged carbon, and you have the symmetrical hydrogen there, which is in syn position. So the answer is clearly B there. Here you have to learn two important things. Thermally, 4 plus 2 cyclohexane is possible, but 2 plus 2 cyclohexane is forbidden. Second thing is syn addition. During the cyclohexane, addition is the syn process. That's why hydrogens are in the syn position. That's all from this episode. I hope it was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below.